Santa Fe officials have been dealing with a lot of bears lately, catching 8 in the last 8 days. In fact, there have been 11 bear sightings since last Thursday. Some of those bears were spotted near schools. Most of them are moms with cubs. Police say they're all healthy, but are searching for food. So please make sure your trash, pet food, and bird feeders are securely put away. So where do all those bears go once they are caught by game and fish officials? Action 7 News reporter Alana Grimm's dad takes us there to check in on all the starving bears that have been caught in the last few weeks. She's live tonight in Santa Fe.
Good evening, Royal. Many bears from all over the state are taken to Dr. Kathleen Ramsey's home and rehab center outside of Espanola. She has one main goal: fatten them up and release them back into the wild. On such a hot day, bears in the wild would be playing around in a stream or lake.
She came from Bernalillo High School.
So here at Dr. Kathleen Ramsey's house, they make do the best they can with a garden hose.
And look at her. She's just bathing her tummy and scratching and just a goof.
The 20 bears at Dr. Ramsey's shelter were caught in cities and roaming through neighborhoods. It's quite simple.
Just a rack of bones.
They're starving and there's not enough food or water for them.
I can't keep track. The bears are falling out of the sky.
And so the bears come down from the mountains. They smell our garbage or bird feeders and they follow their nose.
And there's nothing better than bacon grease in that trash can to bring a bear in. They can smell that for miles.
When many of the bears were caught, they were so thin you could see their bones. They would have never survive because there's so much competition for the little food out there. The bears have to fight each other for it. So many are found hurt and hungry.
Starving to death.
Once they fatten up enough to survive hibernating this winter, they will be released back into the wild where they belong.
These guys get their second chances.
Even if that means leaving the garden hose behind.
And having that opportunity to get back out there and know freedom and life is what I think it's all about.
So the bears have to gain 15% to 20% of their body weight before being healthy and strong enough to be able to be released and survive hibernating the winter. At Dr. Ramsey's, they eat everything from roadkill, fruits and veggies, and sprouts. In fact, she says she goes through about 125 pounds of food every single day. Reporting live in Santa Fe tonight, Alana Grimstad, KOAT, Action 7 News.
Okay, thanks, Alana. Dr. Ramsey is in desperate need of more cages to store the bears, but they're $12,000 each. So if you would like to donate, there is a link with more information at KOAT.com.